Good morning, students. I hope you all are fine. Some of you have sent me query regarding your project work, and some of you are asking repeatedly about submission and all. So here I want to tell you once that if your project work is ready, keep it with you. You will be informed what to do next. So you should not always ask, it's not required, no need to ask me, just keep the file with you, you will be definitely informed. And now the second is, some of you have repeatedly asked me about model. See, in my last class, I think those who are still asking, they have not seen the previous video class. Please do follow all the classes. I think I have very clearly informed you what to do exactly. So as you all were asked to either draw or make model on that, so there is, I think in your English one you can use chart, but here chart is not required at all. So do not just ignore that option. There is no scope to make chart. Okay, you can make a sequence of pictures, that's different, that is not chart. Okay, so whatever I have told earlier, that any of the scenes whichever you like the most, or you feel like, yes, I can draw or I can make a model on that, you can definitely continue with that particular thing. So there is no need to make any chart, as that is not applicable as well. So I think now it's clear. You need to, in A4 size paper, how will you draw a picture? Tell me, is it possible? Will that be, a person be able to understand anything? So it's quite obvious you need to use a full size art paper if you want to draw something. Now some of you have asked what can be, whether it will be thermocol or anything. That depends absolutely on you. You can make it with some clay or that Chinese mud or something, someone was asking. Though I don't have much knowledge about Chinese mud or Chinese clay, I think. I do not know much about that thing. But you can use thermocol. You can do with that also if you can. It completely depends on you, whatever be your material. I only will be finding whether whatever I've asked, whether it is served or not. Now the material or means, whatever you are free to do on whatever part you are comfortable. I hope now it's clear. So we have already completed two chapters from our half yearly portion. The one poem and one prose, and the last one for half yearly portion is The Broken Ear Goes Missing. So this particular part we will be starting today. So before we start, I want all of you to keep your book ready with you, as I have also kept mine. So you need to open the book, and like our normal classes, we will be trying to focus on this chapter. So The Broken Ear Goes Missing, it is obviously, it's from, you all have already heard about Tintin, or all of you have read also. So it is also an extract from Tintin and the Broken Ear, and from that particular part, and we need to read out whatever is there in this. It is in, not in the natural normal paragraph style, it is having something. See, here also, from here also you all can learn, you all can see the way the pictures are said. If the dialogues are not there, then also I think we can somehow guess what the subject matter be. So you got a hint here as well. So now we were first given a table, and we need to match A with B. This particular part today I will not be discussing. This is your task you need to do. Next day I will start with this. Okay, you need to open your I will be discussing the thing, answers will be discussed later. So in option A, we find detectives or investigators. First, now here in column B we find some explanation, and whichever is applicable will be fit to it. So if we have to for first one, I will try to provide you hint. The first one is detectives or investigators. So detectives or investigators, so if we have to explain it, what can be? It can be like characters who try and solve the problem. They are detectives and investigators. So obviously answer for A will be option 6, that characters who try and solve the problem. Okay, let me discuss the questions only. Number B, witnesses. Witnesses, what can be? Characters who saw the crime being committed. Okay, that can be witnesses. Witnesses are the person who see whatever happens in front of them. They just witness that, they see that. That's why. Now number C, clues. Clues can be pieces of information that help solve the mystery. That means option 4. Now number D, red herrings. Red herrings is something meant to distract or fool the people trying to solve a mystery. That is option 3. Number E, alibi. Alibi is an excuse a suspect makes to show that he was not at the scene of crime. That is alibi. Now suspects, number F will be characters who may have caused the problem. They are suspects, and evidence, proof of something. So I have verbally discussed all the answers, though I told I will not do, then I made a change of my mind, and as it is done now. Now you need to do it. This answer you need to do by your own self, though I have discussed this. Now I will not provide it in written form, because nowadays I feel like all of you are not following regularly. So do not send me any kind of request through it to provide these things. These are already discussed. Now you need to rewatch the video in order to solve it. If you can do it by your own self, that is the best thing. Now we have asked, whether have you heard of the Adventure of Tintin, created by Georges Remy, who wrote under the pen name of Hodge. This is the same question to you all also from me. Now the author was an illustrator for a newspaper in Belgium. Who? That Georges Remy was an illustrator, or means illustrator is means who makes up the articles and all. He claimed that the idea for Tintin came to him as soon as he sketched the boy detective in 1929. So in 1929 the author first made a sketch of Tintin, then the character came into his mind. Tintin, now about Tintin you all know still, is an intelligent reporter and adventurer who enjoys solving mysteries along with his dog Snowy. Every adventure brings with it a new challenge as well as risks, and takes him somewhere new. The young detective has other friends, including the clumsy policeman Thompson and Thompson. See, Thompson, the pronunciation will be same, only the spelling is a bit different. Like Thompson, in second case the P will not be uttered. So both the pronunciation will be Thompson, who add a comic element to the stories. The following extract from Tintin and the Broken Ear is his sixth adventure. So the Broken Ear goes missing. This part is thus means is from his sixth adventure, named Tintin and the Broken Ear. This time the young detective and Snowy visit the fictional nation of San Theodoros and travel to the forest where they meet the Umbaya tribe. Now let us read about the mystery of the Broken Ear. So the scene opens here in the Museum of Ethnog. Now here we will learn about ethnography. What is ethnography? Ethnography is the study of people, their culture, about people actually, their cultures as well as their customs, and their habits, etc. So in such a museum the scene starts. So here we find some observer, they have come to visit the museum, and they are means there are some statues and all. We find head of carved wood. Here we find that Aramba fetish which is going to be lost very soon. Now the guard says closing time, and the those who are the visitors, they says gracious, it's already 5 o'clock, means they have not, they have forgotten about time, and all of a sudden they were reminded that it's closing time, and they were quite surprised to observe that how fast the time, that means how fast the time went out, means now now the guard, he closes the door, and here in Tintin's place, Tintin was trying to wake his pet up. Now he says, come on up you gate lazy bones, it's time. Now as we find the clock, it's alarming. Now in the meantime, the guard, he was sweeping the floor, and he was singing a song. All of a sudden he hears something, the third picture we find, and then on the fourth picture we find he runs away. In the meantime, Tintin, he is doing daily exercise. He says, bend knees, raise arms, 1, 2, in this way. Now with the instruction only he does the exercise. Instruction is played over radio there. Now Tintin says, and now a good bath to wake us up completely. Now Tintin was about to take bath. In the meantime, it was a time of the news at 8 o'clock in the morning. Now he hears, while taking bath, Tintin hears that details are coming in of a mysterious robbery last night at the Museum of Ethnography. A particularly real tribal fetish has been taken. So there a robbery took place in the Museum of Ethnography. Ethnography, as I have already explained, that it is the study of people, their habit, culture, custom, etc. So it has been, means a rare tribal fetish has been stolen from that particular place. The theft was discovered this morning by a gallery attendant. As there was no sign of forced entry, it is believed that the thief allowed himself to be locked in at closing time yesterday, waiting for the museum to open this morning to make his getaway. So the way it was, the thief has stolen the thing, it is expected that the thief was there only. So it was not, no sign of forcefully entry or anything. The thief rather took the thing and waited overnight, and when in the morning the museum was opened, he ran away. He made his way to escape from that particular place. Now Tintin says, quick Snowy, to the Museum of Ethnography. Now Tintin rushes to that spot in order to find means the solution. Now he asked the director, Tintin was asking for the director, and the guard was saying, the director, I'm afraid he is busy at the moment. The police are here conducting their inquiries. It's very simple language is used, you all can understand, I think. Now policeman is saying, now let's recapitulate. Recapitulate means let us summarize and utter the main points. Let us summarize the whole incident and only let us speak out only the main things to concentrate. The attendant closed the door yesterday at 17:12 hours, means at 5:12 in the evening. He did not notice anything unusual. These all the things the policemen are saying. They are recapitulating rather. He came on duty today at 7:14, he noticed that exhibit number 3542, the fetish, had vanished and gave the alarm immediately. Is that correct? Good. Now this attendant, is he reliable? Now the director says he is above all suspicion, means he cannot be somehow suspect, he can never be. He has been working here for 12 years and has never given cause for the slightest reproach, means he has been working here for a long time and there is no way to not to believe him. So anyway, the fetish has no intrinsic value and can only have tempted a collector, solely a collector. Now he says the fetish is not having that value, economic value, it's not having an economic value. Intrinsic means having means the economical value, obviously. Now he says, and the person who is fond of collecting all these means belongings, they are natural, they can only be tempted with it. So it's nothing like the thief is going to take it and is going to sell it and get a good amount of money. It's nothing like that. Rather, if the thief is, it is quite obvious that someone who is fond of collecting all these things, that person is only can be responsible for taking this particular thing. Now the policemen, they were leaving, and the director was thinking that now the policemen are leaving and they found Tintin. Tintin said, "Good gracious, what a pleasant surprise." Now those policemen say, "Why, it's our friend Tintin." Means Tintin has helped, as we have already know, we already know Tintin has helped police to solve many cases. So they met each other, and as we have much time, so I think this much is enough for today. What you need to do is, what happens next day, that we will learn on the next day. Today up to this much only we will learn, and what you all need to do is, you all need to reread the passage once again. And one very innovative thing I want you all to do, though I personally know one or two students, they do that. I have read their stories also. They are very good writer of such mystery stories. So I want all of you to to do something of your very own. So if you can do that, that will be good. At least you all start today. Okay, so this much for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.